Hello, Nobues here, and welcome to another modded video. I got the charging stuff to work. I moved it from up here, from right here, to downstairs so I can have a little bit more room when dealing with some stuff. And I basically played around with it. And I'm going to show you how it works here in a second. Alright, so it connects to the network normally. Well, part of it does. Alright, there's an item sync that requests a empty backpack as the default routes to send empty backpacks. Alright, then it will fill it up. And there's an advanced extractor that will only extract full backpacks, which will go in this chest. Now, this part right here could not be connected to this part. For the reason being, if it exceeds a route for an empty backpack or a partially empty backpack, it will automatically extract it without being full. So this pipe is a route for a full backpack only. So it will only accept full backpacks. And this is an extractor that will extract anything from this chest and send it back into the network, which the default route for a full backpack is this right here. Now, I just tested it. I emptied a backpack and filled it up. I would do that again, but I might be able to do it right here. Let's fill that up and wow, yeah. Okay, I should be able to empty this. And then be able to go ahead and test this again. That way I can actually show you how it works with only these two bags. Okay, it has to be a very empty backpack. it won't work with a partially empty or anything else. Well, it might work with a partially empty, but I'm not going to take no chances. So, you got an empty backpack, you're down mining, you fill your empty backpack into the input chest to put it into your system. Okay, in a second here, you're going to see it come down. I'm going to reroute some of these pipes because that's the storage room right there. So it's going to come down. See, there it is. Now you're going to see a ghost image of it. Oh, it didn't do the ghost image this time. Alright, so it's going to stay in there because these pipes doesn't know anything but a full backpack. So it's going to stay in there until it's full. And then it's going to get pulled out into that chest. And from that chest, that extractor is going to extract anything that's in that chest and put it back into the system. Now, if you wait with this, it's going to put it right back in here because this is the only route it can go because it's a full. And it's going to take a second to get up there. That's why I'm going to reroute some of that stuff. See, there it is. And that's just a ghost. So, I got that part working. That was boggling my mind why it wasn't working. I was like, wait, the extractor part of that has to be on its own separate network. Okay, to answer a few different questions that I've been having in comments. Some of you are seeing these signs as a normal sign and asking, oh, how did you put the picture on there? That's awesome. That is not actually a sign. That is using a tool called Crafting Sign Creator, which allows you to do this. So in this version of Logistics Pipes, when you click on Let's just break that so I can show you. Where is that? Supplier? Nope. Right there. So normally when you just when you give it that and you tell it to import, okay, it doesn't do nothing. But with the sign creator, you right click on the crafting pipe and it makes a sign to tell you, okay, there's the ID of the thing and the name and a little picture of it. So it's really, really cool. And I like it. I did move this. I moved my portal over one because that was kind of bothering me having it half over there and so on and so forth. I don't know if I wanted to fill that in with obsidian right there or not. Probably not. I put a prasad over that one. And this right here, if I can get it. Nope, I probably won't be able to get it. But that pipe right there has that full lapiton, the full backpack in there. And when I move up to a lap pack, where it stores 600,000 energy, I believe. Don't quote me on that, I'm probably wrong. We can continue to set up the system the same exact way. We'll just move this and put it back into the system. One thing I want to do is have this power going someplace. There we go. Now the output of this will now be cycled through the system, and when something gets low, it will recycle, you know. And that's something I wanted in the system, redundancy. So that's just adding another backpack in there, or battery box, backpack, bat box, into the system. I really do want to upgrade to MFEs, but I only have 3 diamonds right now, and I need a minimum of 4. So I just wanted to get this mining system up and running so I can get started on some stuff. I'm really debating if I want to do this episode or wait. I have the iron now to do it this episode, but I need to go mining, and that is make a couple of tanks to store liquids in, because I want to store my I want to have a lava tank, and I want to store my oil, and I want to store my refined I can't think of what that's called. Refined oil? Fuel? Yeah, fuel. Okay, simple enough. And if you ever get that, just click on the edge there. It's hard to do, but if you click on the edge, you get rid of that little yellow border. I might actually want one for water, maybe. That way, it fills that tank up and continuously fills the tank up, and that way I have a buffer for these engines right here. I know I want one for clean fuel. What is it? My brain's not working right now. I can't think of it. I want one for lava. Oh my god, my brain is literally like stopped working right now. I can't think of it. Biomass. But that's not it. No, yeah, biomass or biofuel. That's what I was thinking of. Oh, man, my brain. So, I'm happy that I got this working. I played with it. It didn't really take me long to do this. I was like, okay, yeah. The reason why I had to connect it... Actually, sandstone pipe. Sandstone transport pipe. K. Okay, we're gonna make some sandstone pipe and put it right there. That way I save three pipes. Yeah. I don't know why I didn't think of sandstone before. Okay, I need two of those. One piece of glass. Wow. Glowing glass. And I want to get some induction furnaces going with some automation on like making glass and stuff. Because when my glass gets low, I want it to be able to, okay, my glass is low, go smelt me, I don't know, two stacks of the stuff. Okay, sandstone pipes are really, really awesome. They won't connect to machines, pumps, anything. They won't connect to anything but other pipes, and I love them. And I can't believe I didn't realize I can use them here. So doing something like that, I don't have to see downstairs, and it just makes overall cleaner look there, and I love it. And then I can go downstairs and pick up those other two pipes. Another tank I want to make is for creosote oil, because I do want to do stuff with Railcraft, especially in some automation stuff where where I want to like automatically get lava from the Nether and stuff. Which you can do. If you watch Direwolf's episode, he kind of does it. Well, he does. He do. He does it. That's not even the proper way how to say that. He does it. He uses Mystcraft, which I do have on here. I haven't did anything with Mystcraft. Maybe we'll do that in this episode. I don't know. I honestly don't know what I want to do in this episode. Okay, pop that in here. Another thing that I've also done was change over my default chest. If you look down there, there's a Mark II down there with a item sync and a provider module. So that is now done. I tried to put a facade there, but I kind of wanted to make it even with that, and I can. I need to stop being lazy about it and do that. Put that back on there. Get my wrench. This is something I kind of learned to do. Tell you the truth, yeah, I do watch Direwolf's videos, and he accidentally did this in one of his videos to do that, and it allows stuff to go through, and that's pretty freaking awesome that it does that. So all my crafting stuff is still there. Which that is pretty freaking awesome that you can that if you lay it down first, pipes will go through it. Yeah. Gonna be hiding a lot of stuff now. I removed that. Didn't need it. I wanna fix that because, well, where is it? Right here was a double. It's kind of weird. It goes through doubles, but it won't go through singles. There. You see how weird that is? Like, the ones I just replaced were doubles, but it won't go through singles. That's the weirdest thing I ever encountered. Gotta put my light back here. That's a strange glitch. Get back in there too. So, let me get off camera for a second so I can kind of get my brain working again and think on what I really want to do this episode, because I have an idea on what I want to do. What I really want to do is go mining, and I don't like doing mining on camera because it's just too boring. You've seen one person mine, you know how they mine. Caving, that's a little bit different, but I need some diamonds. I want to upgrade my power system to MFEs. Yeah, and I can do that because MFEs is medium voltage. I'll be moving those two over there. This guy already sets medium to high voltage, so actually, let's get prepared to move. Yeah, let's get prepared to move. I want to move this stuff down here. I want to get rid of it for now. Those aren't actually connected to anything. Okay. Oh! I can't believe I did that. Stupid me. Y'all probably hate me or yelling at me. It's like, no, you used a drill on it. I know, I know. I'll remake it. No big deal. No big deal at all. I'm not super low on resources, so. Alright. And then I can replace that with an MFE. And it will not affect any other machine because of that right there. Automatically converts to low voltage. Okay, so I think I'm good. There we go. Alright, I think I'm good on that. And then I'll put those over there somewhere. Alright, so I'll be back. Okay, I just moved those upgrades over here. What I'm going to do is go mining. I need some diamonds. I want to get some more iron. I'm going to be using as much of that iron that I have. It looks like I have a lot. When I make those tanks, I'll be using 90% of that. Probably even more. I'll probably be using most of that. Not all. Probably all. I don't know. Who cares? So I'm going to go mining, now that I can go mining without worrying about power and stuff, because when that gets empty, I can use that while that gets full, and so on and so forth, and I love it. So I'm going to go mining. This episode's running just about time to wrap it up. I know there's not really no meat and potatoes here, just some updates and this thing. I'm just so happy with this. I was wrapping my head on it. Charging princes wasn't working. And I wanted to do it with logistic pipes. And, well, I did it. Good wrapping up point. If you like my videos, go ahead and subscribe to me. The more subscribers I got, the more you guys subscribe, the better the more I know I'm doing better. You know, the more subscribers per day I get, the better, I know I'm doing good. Leave your comments if you have any questions, and I'll try to answer them. I'm not an expert at these mods, but I do know them like the back of my hand, so I can answer some questions. If you want versions, I started putting versions in my subscription so you know what version of what I'm using. 1.4 comes out tomorrow, so I think I'd be doing a lot of work in my vanilla server, my vanilla Let's Play. So, sad to say, this one might not have a really good. I want to say I won't play this, but I know I will. I can't stop playing modded. The good thing about this is most of the mods that I'm using right now are already released for 1.4 or has a 1.4 pre-release client, meaning they are completely ready for 1.4. IC2, definitely ready for 1.4. Forge, definitely ready. Buildcraft, probably not, but close. Logistics pipes, getting there. Railcraft, yeah, there's an update for it. I'm pretty sure they're ready for 1.4. With Red Power 2, you know, she's taking her time with it, and I'm pretty sure she just wanted to skip 1.3, so when 1.4 comes out, there really isn't any major fixes she has to do. I think that's when Red Power 2 is going to come out. Because if she doesn't release it, like, within 2 or 3 weeks of 1.4, the mod is going to be dead. That's my prediction. I'm sorry. If that hurts anybody, I'm sorry, but, you know, she fucked around this long. She needs to release a version of it, or people is going to completely stop using the mod. Right now, I can care less if I had that mod. I can literally do 90% of what that mod does with vanilla Minecraft and the current mods. Some of the higher stuff it does, like frames and stuff, I won't be able to do. But anything redstone it does, I can do with vanilla. So, anyway, like, subscribe, you know the drill. Have a good day.